Right, Royal Canadian Air Force is just passing over Cambridge. There we go, got it. It's 32 times zoom. I can hear it. 68 times, just to try and get a bit of colour on the actual plane. That'll be heading towards kind of Huntingdon, is in that direction where it is now. Just going to zoom out a bit. 7 times. Zoom. I would say that plane is roughly over Huntingdon now, as seen from Cambridge, England. Right, I'm going to lose it behind a tree now, so there you go, leaves that long contrail behind. I'll just show you on a radar screen on my computer what that was, still recording. Give me 2 seconds. So, that just passed over near Hoxton, which is south of Cambridge, Barton, Hardwick. This will be the section I've just been filming from Cambridge. And as I said, yeah, Huntingdon, it's just past Huntingdon, RAF Witten. So, information about that. Registration 177704. A Canadian C-17. They call it something different, I'll show you in a second. Flight number or call sign CFC4004. I'm just going to switch to Freedart. Sometimes they've got better information. Yeah, there you go. So the Canadians don't call it a C-17, they call it a CC-177 for some reason. There's the info. 34,000 feet, speed 421 knots, heading 327 degrees. Hold on a sec, just got to move something. Right, so if I move the map down. So it's almost over Peterborough now, and I'm going to go back out. Ugh. Let's just see where it's come from. So it's passed just to the east of Paris, made a turn near Lyon. The map's not moving too easily. And you can see Freedart's track ends there. I'll be able to show you when the map loads where exactly. Whereabouts is that? They've tracked it from there in Italy, Firenze. But I'm going to switch back to ADS-B. ADS-B's tracking is usually better than Freedart. Let's just see where they track it to. And just to... I'm just going to get rid of all that other stuff. Right, here we go. So they've got it the same, making a bend near Lyon. Now you see, Freedart's tracking ends at that point there. Look at the difference. ADS-B tracks it all the way down the east coast of Italy, across Greece. Let me know, this has come a long way. Over Israel. And it's come from there. And annoyingly, the maps are in a foreign language. Is that Qatar somewhere up there? It's probably... Oh, it's so annoying when they do that. I know that's Bahrain around that area there. So let's work this out. Let me switch to Google Earth. Right, let's leave Cambridge. So this is how to work things out. If you're using one of the maps on Freedart or ADS-B, they've been cheap and not used Google Maps because it costs them money to use those services. So they've used this other map system that's in a foreign language. And then you can't work out where anything is. It's flipping stupid. So, where did I just show that coming from? It's come from past Greece, past Israel, I showed you, didn't I? There we go. Yeah, Bahrain, Qatar. So yes, Kuwait, I was right. Kuwait, so let's switch from that back to ADS-B. Let's try and... So then you zoom in on the ADS-B exchange map. Attempt to work out the same location, so... built-up area, that little curved inlet, and then the airport is there. So now I'm going to switch back to Google Earth. That's found that same bit on the map. So Kuwait City was there. The airport was somewhere around there. Is that an airport there? Yes, there you go. You see how I've worked that out? So that has come from there. Ali Al Salem Air Base. So there you go, that's how to work things out. You have to use a combination of websites to do this, but I've just managed to work out that that is what I've just shown you on Google Earth. Anyway, time's 1:30 p.m., 20th of June, 2020. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.